Morning. Please be seated.
The two world leaders were always polished and cordial in front of the cameras, but the calls reveal a much closer relationship behind the scenes, obvious when Princess Diana died.
They liked her, they loved her.
While Tony Blair was publicly brave, privately he tells Bill Clinton, "I will personally miss her. It's like a star falling." "It's awful. It's really awful," Clinton responds. Blair says, "We saw her again just weeks ago when we hosted her for lunch with Prince William. He's a great kid." Clinton, "I worry a lot about those kids now." Their conversations often revolved around world events, President Clinton fretting after sending an unnamed messenger to Saddam Hussein. "I told him to go to Saddam, call him and tell him that I have no interest in killing him or hunting him down. I just don't want his chemical and biological program going forward. If I weren't constrained by the press, I would pick up the phone and call the son of a bitch." Clinton talks about Russian President Boris Yeltsin. "He served roast pig and told me real men hack off the ears and eat them." And his successor, Vladimir Putin. "Putin has enormous potential," Clinton told Blair. "I think he is very smart and thoughtful. I think we can do a lot of good with him."
"I did have a relationship with Ms. Lewinsky that was not appropriate."
Still, there were limits. Just days after the president admitted a sexual affair with a White House intern, he speaks to Blair in a guarded manner. "I went into Massachusetts and did an event. It was great. I got to work a line and speak to a cheering crowd. There were thousands." Blair, "Good. I'm pleased." Clinton, "This is my best state, you know. If I'd been in Wyoming, they probably would have been shooting at me." In another moment, Blair says, "I'm thinking about you." Clinton says, "I'm slogging on. I think it'll be all right." Some of Clinton's sharpest words are about the next U.S. president, George W. Bush. "Bush is really smart," he tells Blair. "He has these right-wing foot soldiers do his dirty work so he can be nice." These days, the two former presidents are described as close as brothers. But then Clinton called him a fraud, adding, "He is not ready to be president. Maybe not ever, certainly not now." As for the Republicans, they hate us more than we hate them. They don't care as much about government. They just want the power. Maybe foreshadowing his role in her current campaign for president, Clinton praises his wife when she wins a Senate seat. "Hillary is doing great," Clinton says, "happy as a clam. I'm really proud of her." Blair, "She was just fantastic during the campaign. I thought she was just great." Clinton, "Yeah, she was the little engine that could." But family talk dominates as Clinton is leaving office and the Blairs are preparing for a new baby. Clinton, "You getting ready for fatherhood?" Blair, "Well, I'm psyched up." Another time, Clinton, "You know, after January, I'm available for babysitting duties." Blair, "Right, Bill. We'll put you down on the babysitting list now, mate."